Church members are some of the most gossipy people that you will ever meet. Stories and urban legends spread throughout the church at lightning speeds, and most of the times they turn out to be completely untrue. Everyone seems to claim that they know it's true because it happened to someone that they know, like their companion, their sister's mission's president's niece, sure, whatever they say. So I want to talk about some of those popular urban legends in the church that I have heard. Hope you enjoy. So the story goes a little like this. There are a couple of sister missionaries that are driving when they suddenly ran out of gas. So they pull to the side of the road and all they have is a couple of bottles of water. So they do the obvious, which is they put the bottles of water into the gas tank. And then they pray to convert it into gasoline. And it works. I don't know what to say about the story except that it sounds like super dumb. I really hope there aren't people that have really tried this out. So we'll just move on. For the last couple of years, I have heard story after story that the church has been secretly calling missionaries to China. Usually the story goes a little like this. Someone knows someone who knows someone who knows someone who received a calling, but instead of being called to a specific mission, it says something like, your calling is waiting to be assigned, or something else mysterious. Some people even claim that there is a secret missionary group right now at the MTC that is currently preparing to serve a mission in China. And the church is soon to announce that China will be open for missionaries. This one sometimes feels plausible because I'm sure that the church is doing all that they can to open the church in China. But having lived in China in 2016, in my opinion, we still have a long way to go. So we'll move on. This one's one of my favorites I've heard. The story is essentially that the sword of Laban that was passed down through the Book of Mormon is actually currently vaulted somewhere and in possession of the church. And they haven't revealed it for whatever reasons. Some people say it's because the church is enraged to reveal it or that it's being tested on, but there are definitely like crazier theories. One of the theories is that it is currently sheathed and that it's going to become unsheathed or it's going to unsheath itself once the second coming happens. This theory most likely originates from a source from the Journal of Discourses when Oliver Cowdery and Joseph Smith went to a cave and they reportedly saw the sword inside the cave. You can believe whatever you want, but in my opinion, this is really just a bedtime story you tell to your mission companion on the mission. So this is the most popular urban legend you've probably heard from members and have heard some type of variation of the story. So there isn't really one story when it comes to this, the legend of the three Nephites, except they seem to be like the Mormon Avengers. Essentially, they are immortal and they were asked to tarry on Earth till the second coming, right? And I've heard so many members claim that they know someone who has been helped by the three Nephites. These stories range from, you know, saving people from imminent danger to giving them like warnings about the future and you know, helping like people cross the street. Like really, it's a big range. I'm not an expert on the three Nephites, but I have a feeling that they have better things to do other than just helping strangers with their day-to-day problems. But who knows? Maybe they're really bored, and maybe they're even watching this video. I don't know. So that's kind of my short video about like urban legends. So if you know any other or urban legends in the church, please comment below and share them. I hope that you enjoyed this video, and remember to subscribe and comment to keep watching more videos. Talk to you later.